During the late afternoon on May 4th, 2022, storm chasers marveled an extremely photogenic tornadic storm in North Texas. The horrible road network over big country didn't prevent chasers from capturing beautiful images.
Oh, that's bad.
As the low precipitation, high-based storm offered spectacular views from even miles away.
Oh, that's pretty.
For roughly 3 hours and 40 minutes, the isolated supercell spawned tornadoes from southwest of Paducah to near Vernon, Texas, along a snaky 81-mile track.
So good right for us.
But later that evening, as the storm tapped into an even more volatile atmosphere, chasing conditions abruptly became extremely dangerous. The town of Lockett, along with several storm chasers, were impacted by a large rain-wrapped EF3 tornado. This is my account of this incredible storm. The western half of Texas is currently experiencing exceptional drought.
Wow.
The easily lifted dust, tracing every current of wind, revealed this distant weak tornado. The second tornado of the day was a little closer.
lost satellite reception.
Imagine that.
This road is going to end, and then it's going to go crazy. Do the craziness now. We're in the middle of nowhere.
Right when we got trapped in the big country roads, but it's okay. And it's disappearing into the rain.
Tumbleweed. Okay.
be amazed at the wind turbine's strength and durability while taking direct hits from this tornado.
Man, it's cruising.
If you look closely, you can even see the blades bending and flexing in the strong winds.
The turbine is taking it right now.
Also, to prevent damage, turbines automatically cut off when wind speeds exceed 55 or 65 miles per hour.
There's one right there. And let's do something, guys. You can see there's stuff all over my window. Let's do something. Let's turn your lights on.
The storm has now moved into an extremely unstable environment. Higher dew points have brought the storm base lower to the ground, and strong, rainy winds are beginning to wrap around the mesocyclone. A powerful tornado looked to be developing in the rapidly decreasing visibility.
We have the other one still kind of on the ground over here. Oh, looks like I just saw one in the lightning. Like there was one right there. Oh man. It's crazy.
Yeah, I like that.
Okay.
Lurking between me and safety, a daring funnel cloud twisted overhead. Rather than pointlessly risk speeding under it, I gave it a little room to cross the road first. Sort of.
Okay, we got a blast through here. Yeah. I'm inside the circulation. We got it. Okay.
Resisting temptation to stick my neck in the rainy bear's cage, the rest of the evening was spent hoping for a view of the bear. But with a several-mile buffer and multiple paved escape routes.
Just in case that whole thing's a tornado, I'm gonna leave the engine running. Escape route is 3 miles. Okay. Can't see anything. Time is 8:43, and there's obviously a tornado on the ground.
Somewhere in that mess, an EF3 would impact Lockett, Texas, as well as several chase vehicles. No fatalities were reported.
Like a crazy snail on radar, but I don't see it.
That's all, folks.